Okay, so welcome back. So now, if you want to publish our project and to create one Jenkin job, so now for example, Maven Java is our project. Now we want to push this project into our Jenkin job and we want to trigger it from there. So if you want Jenkins to pick that, either you can do from your source code, maybe from GitHub or SVN. So right now, as it is in our local machine, so you have to place this project first in your Jenkins home directory. Then only Jenkins recognizes your project. Okay, so I'll tell you how to do that. So for now, let me create a new job to run our Maven Java framework. So just say new item, and here you can select Maven job only. So that could be our job name, and if you come down, so there are different options present here, so you can just ignore all this and say freestyle project. That's common thing, and click on OK. So it opens a job configuration window. Here you need to provide all the information related to this project and to execute this project. Okay, let's see that step by step. Now, first thing what it expects is you have to provide project code. Okay, so either you can bring the project code from your GitHub source code repository. So in generally in real time, the companies push their code in GitHub or SVN subversions. So they will just pass the link where exactly the code is present, and Jenkins automatically take that code from that link and run your test cases. So right now we don't have any source code, so Git and subversion, but we have code in our local machine, right? So in that case, if Jenkins want to identify your local project, then click on advanced here and you say use custom workspace. Okay, so you have to place your framework project in Jenkins home directory. So let's copy. I'll copy this from, okay, let me take you to the Jenkins home directory. Okay, so first I'll copy my project Maven Java, which is present in Rahul directory, and in the same Rahul directory, once you create and start your Jenkins, you'll see folder like this .jenkins. Okay, so open this and paste your project here. That's all, because this is a home directory of Jenkins. So if you place it here, automatically when you run your job, Jenkins come here and checks for your project. Okay, so we will provide the information now to our job here. Okay, so now we know that it's in our Jenkins home directory, right? So to access, we need to give the path till Jenkins home directory first. Okay, you can give simply by calling this function Jenkins . Okay, so this variable will execute and automatically gives the path to this specific directory in your local machine. Okay, so once you are here with this Jenkins underscore home, when you place in curly braces and add a dollar, so that will give the location till here. But where exactly our pom.xml is lying? Inside the Maven Java, right? So slash, so this is the home directory for a project, Maven Java project, Maven Java. Okay, so in this way, this job will identify your project. Okay, now either it looks for the code of your project from Git or SVN. If you don't provide those links, it automatically comes here and look for the path where exactly your code is lying. So you have clearly mentioned that it is in my home directory with the name Maven Java. Okay, with this information, it identifies and dumps code into this particular job. Okay, good. So we are at this point as we pass the path of the directory, and let's come down. So as source code I told you, right? So either use this or that. Okay, so if you come down, you see that build periodically. So that means you can provide schedule that if you want to run at morning 7 a.m. or morning 1 a.m. or whatever you want. So this I'll talk soon. I'll be talking the next lecture. And you see the build environment and build. These are different sections here. So if you want to delete the workspace before build starts. So basically, while triggering this job, Jenkins will take all this code and dump into this job folder. Okay, in this particular job. So once you are done with the test, if you want to delete the workspace, what it got dumped, you can simply select this checkbox. Okay, so this Jenkins is not only designed for testing purpose. Basically, the developers will use to create jars and to push or deploy their code using Jenkins. So there are a lot of options which we need not go through right now. So our main intention is to pass the Maven command to trigger this execution. That's all. Okay, so even here, what we have done, we have the whole project. We simply passed MVN space test and all our configuration, we just provided in pom.xml, right? So this pom.xml takes all the headache of controlling your test. So once this setup is ready, just to execute this, you need to give a simple command called MVN space test, right? So build your project, and here where you will see the Maven. You see that? Invoke top level Maven targets. Click on this, and if you configure your Maven version in the settings in the previous lecture, then you will see that in your drop down. Okay, so I told you, right, you have to configure Maven in Java in global tools. So if you do that, and here you will see the drop down option. So this points to that location, and that points to your local machine location. So here is where you need to provide a Maven command. Okay, so Maven command should be provided from the path of pom.xml. Okay, so right now we are at that path only. If you see that, till Maven Java we are there, right? So that means we are at this location, and our pom.xml is also here. So you can simply pass your Maven command in the goals section. So I will give MVN space test. We are doing profiling, right? Let's say hyphen P regression. So it should execute all test cases, I guess. So is that the one we are looking for? Yeah, regression. Okay. But so you can ignore this MVN command here, because Jenkins will automatically pre-populate for you that. Okay, so we are going to write Maven commands only, right? So in Jenkins, again, you need not specifically mention. If you give like this, that's all. That's enough. Okay. Now, add post build action. So that means once your tests are run, if you want to publish results and test engine reports and graphs, that all you can do it here. So that I'll be talking in the next lecture. So for now, I'll simply save this job. So what I have given? I have given a path to my project complete code, and then I provided Maven command. That's all. These two are enough, right, to run our code. Let's save this and run our test. Click on save. So that will take you to your home page of your project. So we have successfully created Maven job. Okay, now you want to trigger this. Let's say you are a client and you don't know what is Maven, what is Java, and what your code is doing. So if you want to run a regression, he will see something like this. If you say that Maven job done a regression, does a regression, you will go and just say build now. He'll just click on that link. He is not aware of any knowledge. Okay. So when you click on the build now, automatically you see that build started here. Oh, let me close. I clicked on two times. So you are seeing that. You see that. Oh, it's already done. Let me open and console output. So it's very fast. So total test run 6 and no failures. Cool, right? So for the first time when you execute, it might take time for you because it have to download all the dependencies. But for me, it's already there. So It's very fast. So if you want to see the output and if it failed, for example, and if you want to see the logs, click on the past build and you will see something like this console output, which will actually give all the details. You see that you ran that test and everything passed. Tests ran 6 and all looks good, isn't it? So don't worry, when we are actually injecting either Selenium or API or mobile automation code, in our coming sections, we will again do this with actual code. So now, main intention here is to understand what is Jenkins and what is Maven, and how can you plug in Maven and Jenkins using TestNG. See, slowly we were understanding the components, each and every component individually, and how also, and also how they are integrating together. So with all this knowledge, we will begin our next section and we'll quickly start building the framework from scratch with actual API code. Okay, so we need not waste time again there in understanding what is Maven, what is Jenkins and all. Okay, now let me run again. So you can see that click on build now and you'll see that build started again and you will get the results in within a seconds because it's just a sample test, right? Okay, so that's pretty much about how can you run your project from Jenkins. Right? Is it so simple, right? Just pass a Maven command and worry about all passing technical commands and running the project from Jenkins. So, okay. So in the next lecture, we are going to see about results. Okay, we want to see the results, how the tests are behaving and trending of the test results for each and every job. Okay, right now I have run 2 jobs, 3 and 4. So basically I want to see the job trends, how it is behaving for multiple jobs. And I want to know how many pass and how many fail in form of reporting. So all that we will be seeing in our next lecture. Okay, thank you.